this video, we're going to look at some of the earnings trade we took last week on a demo account. Right? This is not real trades. I just want to test the double diagonal earnings trade where you buy at the money call and put, and also buy next week at the money call, sell at the money call and put on the first week. And then the second week, you just buy at the money call and put. So this is basically a double diagonal setup. Okay. So we just want to see which trades are good and which trades are not good. Okay. So these are basically all double diagonals. So this is the first trade, eBay. Okay, so we purchased at $556, right, at the money. So for 46 debit, and we basically got a credit of $1.11, right? This was in a profit, right? So stock did not move that much. The main key for double diagonal is the stock should not be moving drastically. Okay, so if it doesn't move drastically, you'll make money. Okay. Second is Etsy. Etsy also, we basically put the trade at 128. Okay, so 259 was a debit, and then 380 was the credit, and then we made $363 profit. Okay, it's also a good trade. The second one is SQ. This was a loss. Basically, we purchased for 315 debit, but we were only able to get 98.98 credit. Okay. This was a $1,000 loss, $85 loss. Okay, so the let me show you why that is, right? So you look at the square chart, right? So that basically the stock jumped almost 24 points, right? The expected range was $10, $10 a jump, but it jumped $24, and right? Because of a good earnings report or whatever that is, right? So that is why if it jumps too much, then you will not make money, right? So you have to, it should not jump too much. Okay. Third stock is Oxy. So we bought the Canada spread for 1.09 debit, and then we sold for 1.75 limit credit. So we had a $198 profit. Okay. So three contracts. Okay. Next one is Lowe's, right? Lowe's we basically purchased for 308 debit, and then we made $5 credit. Okay? So this is double diagonal at 217. Right? You can see that sold a put at 217, sold a call at 217. Okay, that was March 4th, and then sold two in February, right? Sold two at February and then bought the two on March. Okay? This is the opening order, right? And then this is the closing order. Okay? So 1 week apart. So here is a chart where lows did not move very high. So that's why the trade was positive. Okay, so it just moved from 206 to 219. Okay. This was basically our expected range. Here's the next trade, open. Open was one thing I was expecting it will be drastically move, but it not move drastically. So we basically bought at 0.33 debit, and then we are able to make 0.46 credit. Okay. So my key takeaway from this is basically you only want to play with some solid earning stocks, right? You should not play with stocks which doesn't have a solid foundation, like for example Lowe's, eBay, Occidental Petroleum, some of the sound companies where the expected move is not that drastic, they have consistent income. So you only want to play with those stocks. So we will we'll also do same kind of earnings trade next week on a demo account, and then we'll show you the results. Okay, it's all double diagonal, so you can see the configuration here. Okay? So you basically buy Okay, sell February 25th and buy March 4th. So the earnings was before 25th. Okay, because I closed it on 25th. I bought it on 24th and closed on 25th. Okay, just one day. Same thing here. Okay. Thanks for watching the video. Please share, subscribe, and comment. If you have any questions, please send us an email. Thank you.